nothing else in life than pool. Play pool, play pool.
Hello, time for some 8-ball. Okay, I will teach you how to run the rack. There are always some problems on the table. And you need to know if you will select the solids or the stripes on the table. And I will teach you how to plan ahead the rack. Put the 8 there. 3-ball is being blocked by the 15. Do you pick the solids or the stripes? That's a good question. I think you should pick the stripes here. For that you need to play position on the 15. You need to fix the 15 very early here. It can be a problem later. Because the 3 is blocking the 15. You can't get good position on the 15. So every shot you do right now needs to be about playing position for the 15. You need to play position for that, and you need to hope. In every shot you need to hope that you are going to get good position. So here I will select the 13 ball. I make the 13 in the corner, play position like this for the 15. If I don't stop here in front of the 15, I still have the other balls to choose from. So that is very good. Okay, so I will do that. Play position for the 15. I hit it way too thin. Way too thin. I don't have a shot on a 15. I will get another chance. I start in the exact same spot as in the beginning. That's really bad. Really bad luck. I don't have any better choice now. I need to pick the 11. I draw back the cue ball, stop somewhere there, and then I want a shot on a 15. If I don't get a shot, I have a shot on other balls. Let's see if I got a good shot on a 15. Yeah, I have a good shot on a 15. I need to choose this shot. I may not get a better chance at the 15 again. Okay, I may not get a better chance. I need to go for it right now. Because if I miss the shot, the opponent will have a tougher time running the rack because I have my other balls on the table as well. So I need to go for it because position for the other balls is not that difficult because I have so many to choose from. So I just need to hit the rail there and come out here somewhere for the other balls. So I will try to get the cue ball go this direction. Then I can make the 14, 9, 10 or the 12. So I'm gonna do that. And I completely missed the shot, but I went that direction that I wanted. So I'll do it again. Let's do it again. Let's do it again. Long top shot. There you go, now I went the direction I wanted. Perfect. I have all of these balls to choose from now. Yeah. Let's see what kind of shot I will choose. This last ball on the table, I think it should be the 12 ball. You can roll in the 12, play position for the 8 in the corner. So, I'll just make the 14. Maybe I make the 10 ball first. No. I make the 14 now, okay? Make the 14, draw back the cue ball somewhere here. I'm worried that I might get stuck with the 12 ball. So I will follow the cue ball somewhere here, play the 9 in the corner instead. So I will just follow the cue ball forward a little bit. There. Ooh, I almost missed that shot, but I hit it with pocket speed. It still went in. Now I will shoot it soft. Play position for the 10 ball. I'm pretty sure I know the reason why I miss so many balls lately. It is because it is getting so dark outside. It is raining. I don't have so much light in here. I don't have so much light with this mask. So that's the problem. In the summer, I played much better when it was much brighter outside. And now it is rainy and very dark. I don't see as good as before. Now I will have, I want an angle on the 12 here to come up for the 8. Can I make a stop shot over here, a stop like this? I'm worried that I need to make a soft roll on the 12, and I might miss the 12. I will draw back the cue ball to this rail instead. Low right spin. There you go. Now I'm a little fuller on the 12. Much better. Here you can make a mistake that by following the cue ball into the rail. You follow the cue ball into the rail and you want it to come back up. Sometimes you end up frozen, you end up snookered behind the one, and you don't want that. So I prefer to just go straight sideways. Make a stun shot. Just go straight like that. That will avoid getting snookered behind the one ball. And now the final shot. There, and the game is over. And that is how you plan ahead. And you saw that right from the beginning, I selected the 15 ball. I wanted to play position for the 15 ball because that was the toughest ball. And without the 15 ball, the rest was very easy. So I was able to get good position on the 15 very early, and that is what made me win the game. Okay, so this is the end of the video. And next time, goodbye.
There's nothing else in life than pool. Play pool, play pool.